Man, is it Friday yet? Oh, it is. Well, that's good news. Hey, Skip, Stephen A., and Molly are all getting a head start on the weekend, so we are jumping in. Welcome into First Take. Prim Sripipat, Will Kane, George Sedano, Freddie Coleman. Guys, how are you doing?
We're well. Yeah? Good to see you guys and lady again.
Yeah, absolutely. We're all wearing kind of black and white. You're the only one with some color there.
Yeah, yeah.
Miami guy.
Gotta throw it down. You know, it's summertime. I know it doesn't look like summertime out here in Connecticut.
It is definitely not.
The rest of the country actually is dealing with spring and getting ready for summer.
It's been raining here for 5 days, but the good news is plenty of hot stuff to talk about. Nice. So let's begin in the NBA. So tonight, LeBron James and company will look to take a 3-0 series lead against the Hawks as the series shifts over to Atlanta. Now, we all saw what the Cavs did Wednesday night, a historic performance as they dropped an NBA record 25 threes. And I love what the Hawks tweeted out at halftime. They said, if you take away their threes, we're right in this. And of course, that tweet was later deleted. So guys, spinning it forward, from what you've seen from the Cavs thus far, can they win a title? George, I feel like you have something to say about this.
I would say the answer is no, unless there is a real injury, a serious injury. And look, we're dealing with one with Golden State. We don't know Steph Curry's situation, but we do believe that he's going to be back and he's going to be healthy. I know that our Dr. Mark Addicks, who's one of our sports injury experts here at ESPN, he felt that that injury initially was maybe a day-to-day thing. He was surprised that it would go a couple of weeks. So it looks like Golden State is being more, precautionary. They're dealing with a precautionary situation there. So I think as long as the Warriors are healthy, they're the team to beat. I think the Spurs are better than the Cavs, and there are a number of reasons. As great as the Cavs have been on offense, they've been fantastic. We mentioned the three-pointers there, certainly. Their offense is the best offense in the postseason right now, okay? But here's where they struggle. On defense, okay? Worst defensive rating of anyone in the postseason, and it's not close, okay? And that's all the teams that are left in the postseason. Then you have the fact that, let's take a look at the individual matchups, okay? You have Steph Curry versus Kyrie Irving. That's what we're going to see again, right? Kyrie Irving ranks 81 out of 85 qualified point guards in defensive real plus minus. What that really means in English is he's a turnstile on defense, okay? So defense wins championships. The Cavs are the 10th best defense in the league, even though they were the 4th best offense in the league. Warriors and Spurs both inside that top five in both categories. To me, those two teams are on a different level, different stratosphere than the Cleveland Cavaliers. As great as LeBron is, I just don't trust the surrounding cast. You guys trust J.R. Smith in a big spot on offense or defense? Because I sure as hell don't.
Mm-mm. Well, first of all, the question is, can the Cavs win an NBA title? And I would say not only is the answer obviously yes, but the smart money is on the Cavs. If you're picking one team, put your money on the Cavs. The debate is not who's the best team. You point out the Warriors and the Spurs are better teams than the Cavs. That's great. That's fine. But in order to win an NBA title, you have to get to an NBA title championship series. And either the Warriors or the Spurs are not going to be there. Only one of those teams are going to make it to that championship series. The point is, the Cavs have a cakewalk into the series. They're guaranteed, they're virtually guaranteed to be in the championship series. This Miami-Toronto, it's the definition of mediocrity. It's the biggest nothing prelude we've ever seen. The Cavaliers will be the Eastern Conference championship. You can say that with about 100% certainty. But you can't say who the Western Conference champions will be. Maybe the Spurs, maybe the Warriors. But they, one of them, in order to win that championship, they're going to have to be there, and they're going to have to survive a tough series, most likely against one another, to get there. That in and of itself gives the Cavs the answer to can they win it. Then it comes to the probability of will they win it against one of those teams. And I want to you point out some interesting defensive stats. Last year, and I know it's last year, I know it was 2015, not 2016, the Cleveland Cavaliers took the Golden State Warriors, the vaunted Golden State Warriors, to six games with a lineup that did not have Kevin Love and did not have Kyrie Irving. Now, perhaps that defense, George, that you're pointing out, is a net loss to the Cavs. I don't think so.
It is.
I think having Kyrie Irving on the floor is a net positive for the Cavs. I think having him play more minutes than Andrew Dellavedova is a net positive. You give me Kyrie Irving and Kevin Love plus LeBron James, whose last year, his championship series is one of the most underrated performances of superstardom history. Incredible series by LeBron. I would say to you, smart money's on the Cavs. They're going to be there at least. We know that.
Cavs have more than a puncher's chance to me to win an NBA championship, because I go back to, if you have the kind of road that you have to deal with in the Western Conference, it's not the Western Conference of last year. The Western Conference come back a little bit. I mean, I think the teams last year overall in the playoffs were stronger than the teams we're seeing. The top three is still terrific. When you got Oklahoma City, then San Antonio, then Golden State. The East is a little bit better, but Will, to your point, if the Cavs don't make the NBA Finals, then they all should leave Cleveland because they have no business not getting through the Eastern Conference. Miami may represent a challenge. They might get two games at best. If Toronto beats Miami in the Eastern Conference semifinals, they're not getting one game off Cleveland in the Eastern Conference Finals. There's no excuse, in my opinion, for the Cleveland Cavaliers to not to get the NBA Finals when they're clearly above everybody else in the Eastern Conference. But I go back to a team. I'll go back to a player in LeBron James. I don't think there's any doubt in my mind. He has the most pressure of any athlete in sports right now for all the reasons that he decided to leave Miami and go back to Cleveland. He didn't go back
even
to Cleveland.
Even more than the Golden State Warriors.
Steph Curry's got the title. He's already done that. But he didn't have to worry about leaving a place to go back home to win an NBA championship. LeBron, he's a prima donna. I love the guy. He's very thin-skinned. He's a prima donna. I'm okay with that because he wants that pressure. Well, you know what? You got it. That pressure, I think, will drive him and motivate him. And I think whatever back and forth they had during the season where guys were rolling their eyes, LeBron James saying this and saying that, it seems that has gone away because, like, oh, man, he was exactly right because look what we're doing right now. And we should not be having any kind of tough series against anybody. They got rid of the Pistons. They had a couple of tough games early. They're going to get rid of the Atlanta Hawks. That's going to be a sweep. They're going to get to the NBA Finals, and I give them a 50-50 chance of winning it because of that motivation. They're going to be a lot healthier. Kevin Love, you can say Kevin Love and Kyrie Irving are not great defenders. We all know that. That's not news. That's like water is wet and grass is green. We clearly understand that. But I'd rather have both of those guys to help me offensively in a fight that's going to be a fight in the NBA Finals where LeBron last year was playing one hand behind his back. And let's remember, with that one hand behind his back, Cleveland had a 2-1 lead in the series against Golden State before Steph Curry and Klay Thompson, those guys went off. And when they do that, it's impossible to stop them. I give Cleveland a 50-50 chance to win the NBA championship because they're a better team than they were last year.
Here's the thing. If you look at when the Warriors struggle, and I'm going to put that in quotes because let's face it, they don't struggle very often. When they've had some issues, it's when teams muck it up with them. Whether it was the Memphis Grizzlies last year. We've seen the Spurs do it a little bit this year. We saw the Cavs do it when Kyrie and Love went down. If Kyrie and Love were playing in that series, they'd be playing right into the Warriors' advantage. You want to speed it up? Go right ahead, because nobody plays that speed game better than the Golden State Warriors. So that's a huge disadvantage when you have those two guys, particularly Kyrie on the floor defensively. Now, I'm with you in the sense that I think Cleveland is going to the NBA Finals. But I don't think it's 100% guaranteed they're going to the finals because you're talking about two guys with a serious injury history in Kyrie Irving and Kevin Love, and you're talking about a Miami team that has won two games against them in blowout fashion in Miami, and there's a lot of people in Miami, I'm just going to say maybe Pat Riley included, that think that LeBron kind of gets in his own head a little bit, that he's such a basketball savant, he overthinks it, he tries too hard. And they're counting on that to be able to at least be in that series. And I do think they'll be in that series because of that.
With all due respect, George, I can't tell if you figure out that the Cavaliers are better or worse with Kyrie and Kevin Love. I mean, if they get hurt again, you have an injury history.
Because you make it,
but to your point,
no, because
maybe they're better without them, according to your argument.
Because it's a matchup thing. Styles make matchups, man. And that's the difference. In sports, that's the way it works. Not just because they may be a better team overall over 82 games doesn't mean that in that individual matchup they'd be better off with those guys.
And to this point, George, matchups versatility is actually one of the reasons I think the Cavs have the ability to play with Golden State. Or the Spurs, I'm not even going to deal with Miami. They're going to walk right through Miami. Reaching the finals and playing Golden State or the Spurs. This season, the Cavs have figured out a way to play that Golden State ball. Granted, not as well as the Warriors. While the Warriors set an NBA record for three-pointers this year, the Cavs were fifth all-time. The Cavs, you got, what is it, Kyrie Irving, J.R. Smith, and Richard Jefferson all shooting over 50% from three. Will that continue? That would be a hard argument to make. But they're now playing a game where they can shoot the three. That's one way they can play. The other way they can play is to muck it up, have LeBron drive in, and finish the basket. I like a team that can play two different ways. I'm telling you, you're underselling the Cavaliers.
So what you're telling me is you'd rather have the generic store brand over the real brand. You'd rather have, you know, store brand soda as opposed to Coke or Pepsi.
Because the Cavs don't play the way the Warriors play. No one plays like the Golden State Warriors because that's the kind of team that they are. But I'm not going to call the Cleveland Cavaliers a generic store brand.
They're Czech. They're RC Cola compared to the Warriors being Coke.
If you're talking about the offense,
yes, there's
they
not
They have
even
LeBron
debate.
James.
They do.
They are not. There's no definition of which they are RC Cola.
Yeah, there's
they
no
can
way.
Play
yeah.
RC Cola at times if they want to against Golden State, and then they can give it to the original.
Do
the real
make RC Cola still, by the way?
Hey, you brought it up. You tell us.
No, I'm just saying. I just figured generic story.
This metaphor is running here. But they can play LeBron James hero ball if they need to. And they can play three-point shooting with J.R. Smith if they need to. The point is, the simple question here, can they win the title? The answer to that has to be obviously yes.
I think a puncher's chance? Sure. I don't think they're better than the Warriors. I don't think they're better than the Warriors or the Spurs, because you know what? They got to defend those teams, and their defense isn't good.
I'll say this. I think if it's a Cavs-Warriors final, I'm still going to go on the side of Golden State. They're the best team, in my opinion. If it's a Cavs-Spurs final, I'm taking Cleveland, because San Antonio has had trouble with perimeter speed. We have seen that with Golden State. We saw it in game two when Russell Westbrook and those guys in perimeter got in their behinds by being aggressive early. And San Antonio, for the grace of God, they have LaMarcus Aldridge, who's been unbelievable in the first two games of this series. Oklahoma City's like, well, we can't stop him, but we're going to make sure that it's going to be hard for your perimeter defense to stop us. That perimeter offense of the Cleveland Cavaliers, when that ball's hopping all over the place, I know it's Atlanta. I'm trying to compare Atlanta to San Antonio and Golden State. Would never do that in a million years. But if they play like that against a Spurs team that struggles on the perimeter defensive side.
Oh, no. Freddie, they're the best defensive three-point team in the league, the Spurs. They allow the least amount of three-pointers of anyone in the league.
No, I'm talking about perimeter defense where you can get into the defense, kick it out the shooters. In a playoff series, that's going to matter with a guy in LeBron James that can find people and knock down shots. They're not getting wide open shots against like they get against the Atlanta Hawks. And by the way, Atlanta, if you're going to complain about someone knocking 25 3-pointers against you, how about getting mad and stopping those guys
and
shooting their 3-pointers?
Hawks need to stop whining. Like, stop.
You're whining about a team busting you in the face with 25 3-pointers. Yeah. Where was that anger before the game got started in game two? So let's put that
professional
aside.
Professional sports. There's no running up the score in
professional sports.
Thank you very much. Especially not in the playoffs.
And especially the last 5 minutes of the third quarter and the fourth quarter, LeBron, Kyrie, and Kevin Love were nowhere to be found. That's why the Hawks are going to be dismissed in the series.
Yeah, let those bench dudes score all they want.
Exactly. They need to get run. But I think the Spurs perimeter defense will struggle, especially the way that Cleveland's playing basketball. I can see Cleveland beating them more likely in a series than Cleveland beating Golden State, but they're going to make the NBA Finals. I can't see Hawks coming back.
No, I think so, too. I think we're in agreement. I just don't think it's, like, 100%. I'm not an absolutist in general. I give at least the Cavs a 100%,
maybe
the 100%
small. I'll give the Heat 2%.
No, I'll give 100%. I don't think they'll beat them in a series.
You're in the right seat for that prediction.
Wow. Nice.
Listen, what about if it's the Cavs and Warriors, what about a Warriors without Steph Curry? Then who has a chance there?
Listen, if the Warriors don't have Steph Curry, they're not beating the Spurs, I don't think.
Let's say it's the Warriors versus the Cavs without Steph Curry.
Oh, no, but they won't get there. If Steph Curry's not playing against the Spurs, they're not beating
the Spurs.
No. Okay. Look, and the Warriors, this isn't to take anything away from them. They have two All-Stars in Draymond Green and Klay Thompson. They got 4 or 5+ defenders on that team. Like, they're really good. This notion that is Steph really the real MVP? I've seen some of that floated out on Twitter. I think it's silly. They have a very good team. They'd be a 55-win team even without him. They just wouldn't be the team representing the West in the finals if they were without him.
I said LeBron has the most pressure. I think the Warriors still have the most motivation.
LeBron always has the most pressure.
Yeah, but the Warriors have the most motivation to me, and here's why. Because they want to tell all the naysayers, shoot, with last year. Well, Mike Conley got hurt in the series versus Memphis. Well, you didn't play the San Antonio Spurs. Well, Cleveland didn't have Kyrie Irving and also Kevin Love. You guys were a charm team. What did they do this year? They went out and hit people in the mouth with 73 wins. Anytime that there's a slight against Golden State, they are really good at ingesting that and taking it out and punishing you. I guarantee you they're hearing all about, well, if we don't have Steph Curry, we wouldn't beat the Spurs. They're like, well, we're going to get him back, but we're going to show you that even without him, we would win a championship. They have the most motivation of anybody in the playoffs.
I want to point out, as we sit here today and analyze the odds of who can and who possibly will be the NBA champion, these things factor in. Steph Curry's unknown. When will he play again? How severe is that injury when he gets back on the floor? Are all part of the calculation we make today. And it's part of the reason I say the Cavaliers are being undersold. There's a smart money on the Cavaliers. And by the way, we can't be cutting Golden State slack, because last year the Cavs played without two of their three best players. If they can do it, let's see if Golden State can do it.
Well, but Steph Curry's the equivalent of LeBron. The Cavs wouldn't be there without LeBron. Like, let's be that's ridiculous. Let's not be silly either.
Playing without two of your top three players. Well, they're not the same as Steph. Right. Fine.
ESPN's Basketball Power Index, if they do have Steph Curry, Golden State has an 83% chance of beating the Cavaliers. But numbers never lie, right? Sometimes they do lie.
I'd be there first.
Sometimes they do.
The truth never lies, though.
All right. Well,